Everybody hear me back there? Okay, my name is Bogart. I'd like you to just double check your seat belts, make sure it's all fastened and everything else is secured. We have safety briefing cards in the aircraft if you'd like to review the briefing given to you earlier by the ground crew. For the front seat, the cards would be on a door or between the two seats. Back seat, we have pouches back to front seat with the cards. Along with the cards is the Aloha bags. We have gray Aloha bags, or they may have blue packages with white Aloha bags in it. You're welcome to it if you need it. Fire extinguisher on the floor, right side of my seat. First aid kit is not in the cockpit, it's in the cargo compartment, right side of the aircraft behind us. So if you need a first aid kit, you have to exit the cockpit, right side cargo compartment. Peter, now if your right leg, you see the red handle on the door? If we have an emergency and a door cannot be opened from the inside or the outside, just remove the plastic, pull up on the handle, and the whole door is going to fall off the aircraft. The only other time you'd have to use that red handle, if we land on the water, the floats will block the door, so you have to use that red handle. The normal handle for the door is behind your elbow, go to the window, lift that lever up, those swings open. The mica, you're sitting next to the door that slides to the rear. Now, two steps in opening that door. First, you need to unlock it, and that'll be the lever bar by your forearm. Once you unlock the door, the second step would be to lean on the very back of the door so it moves the back out about an inch or more, and only at that time you'll be able to slide the door to the rear. If you do not move the back out, if it's unlocked, you won't be able to slide the door to the rear. Another way to do it is lean on the back, maintain the pressure, then you unlock it. It'll pop the back out, and you can move the door to the rear. Okay, we've got cameras on board. Everything I'm saying is being recorded, so when we get back from the flight, if you'd like to look at the video, talk to the clerk behind the counter, and they'll put the chip in the computer. You can see what the flight is like. Other than that, just make yourself comfortable. We'll be airborne in a second here.
Through the trees singing sweet harmony to you softly. With the grace of her hand, she can tell you that a star only glitters at the setting of the sunshine. With the grace of her hand, she can tell you that the wind only blows when no mountainside is there to touch her. Now there's the sun and the moon talking stories, telling tales about a new day. Be a nice day. Now the moon is shining bright and the sun will rise again to start a new day. With a grace of her hand, she can tell you that a star...
Prince Airport is privately owned.
With the grace of her hand, she can tell you that the wind only blows when no mountainside is there to touch her. Now there's the sun and the moon talking stories, telling
passing of the Prince Hill Ranch. Besides cattle, they do activities. They've got trail rising horses, commercial zip lines. It's located in a valley on the left beneath the nose and to the right front. They have numerous zip lines. They have kayaks you could get on the river. They do tours of the ranch and ATVs or by horseback. When we clear the homes, right side will be entering Hanalei Valley. That'll be the valley off the right side.
Hear the winds through the trees singing.
Hawaii would be one of the last places on Earth that was inhabited by mankind. Polynesians arrived between 400 and 500 AD. They currently came from the Marquesas, the Society Islands, Tahiti. And there were supposedly continuous contact between Tahiti and Hawaii thereafter. The island of Kauai would be the fourth largest island in the state of Hawaii, and that's not very big at all. We have eight major islands. It's approximately 25 by 33 miles. It is the oldest of the eight major islands. The oldest part of the island is a canyon. Waimea Canyon. The canyon is a little more than 5 million years in age. The bright colored trees and the Florida Valley are state trees called the kukui nut tree or cantaloupe. Every part of the kukui nut tree was used by the ancient Hawaiians. The bark for tapa, trunk for making canoes. The kernel and the nut is edible, it's very oily. They'd use the oil in lamps in the past. Bracelets and leaves are made from the shell that till today can be found in gift shops. Highly polished black shell, normally sometimes brown in color. The green carpet, you may notice along the sides of the river valley, is just one of the many varieties of ferns we have in the state of Hawaii, staghorn fern, bush type of fern plant. We're on the north side of Mount Waialeale, the very end. There's Mount Waialeale in the right front. It's one of the world's wettest points. In 1982, they recorded over 640 inches of rainfall on its summit. The record year for Waialeale. And we're approaching the very end of Hanalei Valley. We will be leaving Hanalei. Then hop over the ridge once again on the other side. It'll put us in the Kauai Ha District. That side, the rim of the crater eroded down to the riverbed. And we have an opening. And we'll be going through that opening to get into the crater. The rim of the Waialeale crater had a spiritual significance to the ancient Hawaiians. And they erected one of the most sacred temples on the island on its rim, built the temple to a god called Kanei. And there were four major gods. There were Kanei, Kanalua, Lono, and a war god known as Ku Ka Ilimoko, Kani being the most powerful. Now, one of the altars where they did their worshiping on the rim still exists. It's called the Kaavaku. At those times, they did human sacrifices under the tapu system that governed their way of living. At the back of the crater on the left, on the rim, on the top, is Kauaikini. It's the highest point on the island, 5,200 feet above sea level. And we're in a crater between 2,500 to 3,000 feet. And we're exiting the crater. From here we can see the silhouette of the sleeping giant. The mountain on the shoreline to the left and at the center, the highest point, is the forehead of the giant. Left of center, its chin, ominous chest, belly, lower left, knees, and fetus conline on its back. There are probably trails, a couple of them take you to the forehead. On this side and on the ocean side. The town of Lugo is on the shoreline up front. It's where the colony seat is located. The main airport is off of that same coastline, and the shipping center for the island, now Willy Willy Harbor, is there. We have two deep draft commercial harbors on the island. Now Willy Willy is the main harbor. The other deep draft harbor would be Port Allen. Now as far forward, as we can see at a distance, the flat area between the two hills. It's called the Knutsen Gap, named after the Knutsen family. The family at one time owned all the land between the two hills, and they go way back into the Hawaiian history of the island, early missionaries. Missionaries arrived in Hawaii in 1820. They initially came from the East Coast, from the Boston area. Now the main highway, the only road that will take you to each end of the island, we don't have a road that goes around the island, but the road goes right across the gap from left to right, and it continues to the other side of the mountain to the end of the road and towards the Waimea Canyon area. If we were to fly through the gap to the shoreline, we end up on the south end of the island. Poipu is off of that side. The only way to get there is through the gap. Poipu is another designated resort here on the island. That side of the island developed way before the north side where we just came from. They have the Hyatt Regency, Kahuna, the Sheraton, Waiohai, and quite a few other resorts and hotels off of the shoreline. The old town of Kaloa is over there. The old town of Kaloa is where the first successful sugar mill in Hawaii was established at in 1835. Today we do not grow any commercial sugar in the state of Hawaii. The last sugar plantation was shut down ending of last year on Maui. You can pick sugar and pineapple a lot cheaper in third world countries than growing sugar or pineapple in the state of Hawaii. When we cross the ridge, there may be some turbulence. The winds are fairly calm today, so if there is, there shouldn't be that much turbulence. So. Town of Kalaeo is on the side of the hill on the left side. That's the third largest town on the island. Above the town on top of the hill is a municipal golf course. It's called Kukuyolono. Nine holes. Beyond the golf course, the dark green fields, coffee, it used to be sugarcane up until 1989. Beyond the coffee fields, Port Allen, the other deep draft commercial harbor. Inland of Port Allen, Hanapepe Town. Then there's fields along the shoreline. As you can see, most of that is abandoned sugarcane fields. You can see the privately owned island Ni'ihau on the horizon, that elongated island, tiny out to the right of Lihua. No one lives there. But Ni'ihau and Lihua is under the Kauai County seat. And we're about to enter and descend down into the Hanapepe Valley. In 1992, Steven Spielberg and his crew was on the island filming the original Jurassic Park movie. Hanapepe is one of the many locations he was making the movie. If you ever seen the original movie, very beginning, to show the helicopter landing in Jurassic Park, that's the falls. Well, the falls at the bottom of the valley with the pond at the base in front of us is where the scene was done at. And it'll be on the left side in a few seconds. They have numerous waterfalls in Hanapepe. Spielberg was back on the island in 2014, did another sequel to Jurassic Park that was released just last year, released in May of 2015.